Okay, so things are not moving as quickly as we would like to see, but things are happening in terms of coronavirus treatment. So I want to update that. Now, over time, there's going to be so much more happening that I can't realistically in one video squeeze everything in. So what I'll do is I'll quickly update you on what we've had up until now, and then I'll get to the new stuff. So coronavirus being a virus, not a bacteria, we're looking at vaccines, antivirals, and antibody treatments, not antibiotics. There are now vaccines entering stage one clinical trials on humans. First step is make sure that the vaccine is remotely safe, not causing terrible side effects. Then you start following volunteers with different doses, usually over a year, see what's the effective dose, antibody generation, etc. We're in that process. Number two, antivirals. I already told you about remdesivir and Avigan. These are being tested on small groups of patients. Both have significant side effects and only possible efficacy. Anecdotal evidence so far, we need the results of the trials that are ongoing. And then lastly, on Monday, I told you about some antibody treatments, multiple labs and researchers exploring antibody transfusions from patients who have recovered. That's pretty inefficient right now. You need antibodies from one recovered patient can be used on one sick patient with risks. So that's just an idea right now. That's what we covered Monday. Let's now get to the new stuff. Chloroquine is being tested. Chloroquine, maybe better pronounced. Chloroquine is a malaria prophylactic and treatment. It's not new. Chloroquine's been around since 1934. It's available generic. It's cheap. We're talking pennies to a few dollars per dose. There are already some papers on this, including one called Expert Consensus on Chloroquine Phosphate for the Treatment of Novel Coronavirus Pneumonia. Elon Musk recently tweeted about chloroquine. I believe he was given chloroquine when he actually had malaria, if I recall correctly, got people paying more attention to it. What does the study say? The study says that so far, quote, we found that treating the patients diagnosed as novel coronavirus pneumonia with chloroquine might improve the success of treatment, shorten hospital stay, and improve patient outcome. This is early research. It's up in the air. We also heard from French research professor Didier Raoult, who said that the first COVID-19 patients he treated with chloroquine saw a rapid and effective speeding up of their healing process, a decrease of how long they remained contagious. That's good news. We need more testing. All right. He said we were able to ascertain patients who had not received the drug containing chloroquine were still contagious after 6 days, but of those that got chloroquine, only 25% were still contagious. Small sample, but that's good. We also have a new US academic study that says the same. It's a study called An Effective Treatment for Coronavirus. It's by Todaro and Rigano, which says the use of chloroquine is showing favorable outcomes in humans infected with coronavirus, including faster time to recovery and a shorter hospital stay. Promising, need to keep researching. Then we've got a lot of noise about interferon alpha 2b, a bunch of articles from Cuban media claiming that this is a cure. We don't know yet. There's hope that this antiviral interferon alpha 2b could help. It has helped with viruses similar to COVID-19. We just don't know yet. And the idea is, again, use these medications to prevent cases from getting as serious. And then lastly, there's the idea of using two drugs, lopinavir and ritonavir, in conjunction with chloroquine or not. And there are studies which show that in vitro, lopinavir and ritonavir, sometimes combined with chloroquine, can work against viruses like coronavirus. Again, this is in vitro. We have no clinical studies on patients. So it's early, like I said. Keep isolating. It's not fun. It's boring for a lot of people. I want to go out, see my friends, hang out at cafes, not worry at the grocery store. I get it. But we've got to work together to save lives and reduce transmission until we make progress. Things are happening. There are a lot of things in the hopper, so to speak. We have to let the doctors and the scientists do their thing. In the meantime, don't fall for any scam cures. And I'll talk more about that later on in the program.